Everyone, it's Justine the Twilight Stamper. Today I'm bringing you another really awesome card featuring the Sun Bunny special stamp set from Jessica Lynn Original. Today she's doing a blog hop and I have the link in the description below so you can check it out. There's also a giveaway being available for the stamp set and you can go and leave a comment and get a chance to win. Using your boning folder, I'm just going to fold it at that 5.5 inch crease that I just made and make sure that my fold is really crisp so that the card stays relatively flat when laying down. I'm going to be taking this honeycomb folder from Sizzix. I'm putting this so that it's only in the front part. It's not going to emboss the whole card, just the front panel of it. I'm just taking a tag here that I'm going to be using later to measure exactly where I would like the honeycomb to be. I sent that through my die cutting machine and then ended up with this sort of partial embossed look. I cut out this die here and it is a die from Memory Box and it is called Corner Bow. So I'm just going to apply a little bit of adhesive on the back here and then attach it to my card. You're going to attach it to the top left corner. The only parts you're actually going to see are the kind of the top and the bottom of this die, so don't worry too much about the middle. And I kind of just curved it so that the bottom part was more in the center of the card, and then I didn't put any adhesive on that little swirl at the bottom because I ended up having it overlap this piece of cardstock here. So this paper that I'm using is from Paper Crate and it's the Kiss Kiss collection and it's a 6x6 paper pack and I'm just going to attach some 3D tape on here and attach it to my card base. I'm using 3D foam tape from Close to My Heart. It's my favorite 3D foam tape because I think it has a perfect thickness and it's easy to take off with long nails, which is very important when crafting. I stamped this bee and flower stamp from Jessica Lynn Original. That's the start of our blog hop today. I have a link in my description on my blog, which is also in the description, that will tell you the name of the stamp and you can go right to the store and get this really awesome stamp. And you can hop along with the blog hop and see many different projects creating it. So I'm just using some various Copic markers to color this in. I'm using black 100. I'm using Y13, I used N0 natural gray, and for the flower I used RV10 pale pink, RV11 pink, RV20 blush, and for the stem I used YG95. I didn't do a ton of shading on this card, a little bit on the flower. I just didn't find it super necessary. And also the colors that I chose, how I chose them for this tag, was based on the actual pattern paper that we stuck on the front. If you notice, it has black, it has that green color, and those pinks. So I wanted something that coordinated really well with that. So I'm going to attach the tag, also using 3D foam tape again. I debated about putting a sentiment, and here you can also see that really awesome stamp set, but I decided that there wasn't enough room on the tag and it would look cluttered if I added it. So I ended up adding an embellishment title afterwards. So I added just three pieces of the 3D foam tape and I placed it at the same angle as our patterned paper on here. Again, I think the colors in the pattern paper are well represented on the tag and I think that's why it looks so cool. I added this clothespin embellishment. I thought that the wood embellishment really went well with this card and because it's such a natural look with the stamp and the bee and the flower, and I thought it fit really well. To go along with the wood embellishment, I put this chipboard sentiment on here from Create a Smile. I have those in the link on the description as well. They're super cheap and they're flexible embellishments so you can curve them and they're one of my really favorite things to use for titles at the moment and they're really cheap so take a look at those and she has some awesome stamps on her website as well. So I just used some Tombow Mono Glue to stick this down. It's strong enough to hold it and it's one of my favorite glues to use at the moment. I just stuck that sort of in the middle and it's overlapping the tag on the pattern paper and I love the way that it looks. Take a look at the finished result. I think this card is super elegant and gorgeous. Thank you so, so much for watching my tutorial and be sure to stick around to the end to see more videos. In the description below, I have a direct link to the blog link for this card, and there if you leave a comment, Jessica will pick a winner for the stamp set. Here are two links to other videos that you can use featuring Jessica Lynn Original stamp sets. Thanks so much for watching.